Welcome back to my channel. So I just want to make a statement. We're a little bit
lit.
And so wait.
This girl.
Wait, I have the script in my head. I have the script in my head.
Oh, okay.
I'm just trying to get it together. So we are refilming the intro because the first one didn't turn out so well. Basically in this video we're just gonna be getting lit with you guys, and we're gonna be like doing like a truth or drink kind of like questionnaire. Mm-hmm. You guys are gonna be seeing like super like intimate dirty questions. Yes. So I hope you're ready for that.
Let's get started.
We're at Christina's house and we have some Captain. We're already two shots in, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, so we're two shots in, and this is just gonna be a drunk progression of clips, really.
Sorry. Of my rowdy little pups down here. Okay, cheers.
Okay. So we're gonna be playing a drunk. What is it? Drunk or truth? Truth or drunk? Truth or dare. So you basically, if you have to answer the question. If you don't want to answer it, you have to drink. So first question.
Something you miss about your last serious ex?
Probably the way he made me feel. And in bed.
In bed.
Good time. When was the last time you lost your cool? How or what happened? How do you feel about it now? Or you can drink.
I'm gonna drink.
So this is like the first round. This is like the normal version. And there's what? There's like the dirty version, the party version, and
intimate,
then like a mix. Oh,
intimate? And then there's the mix.
The mix. So we're just getting started.
What's something you think people should appreciate more about you?
When I go out of my way to do things for them. It's not like I need the appreciation or like I need validation for it, but it's like, you know how you do things like, for people and then you just like go out of your way to do it and then you keep doing it and then they just like eventually they start taking advantage of
it. Advantage, yeah. Mm-hmm. And they don't like reciprocate.
Yeah.
I had to put him away because he just keeps getting in our faces.
He's very jumpy.
Video, yeah,
he's very
the
jumpy.
Video, we had to kind of put him back.
Yeah. So, of the people here, who is overdue for some kind words? So let's offer some good vibes now.
Wait, say that again? Of the people here.
I mean, there's just the two of us.
Who is overdue for some kind words? Let's offer some good vibes now.
I mean, we're both having good vibes.
Hannah, she's giving. She's sweet. She's amazing. Beautiful.
Thank you.
What's the meanest thing you've seen me do?
Meanest thing? I don't think, no.
Other than be like sarcastic and shit?
I don't think she's mean. I just feel like you're aggressive to your man sometimes. But I feel like that's just your personality, you know?
That's just us.
Yeah. Sometimes you have to be aggressive to get your point across.
True. True.
I don't think I've ever seen you do anything mean, though.
Yeah. Dude, we should change.
Yeah, let's change it.
Okay, from normal. Okay.
Look it. So these are all the options. Which ones do you want us to pick? Okay, we'll pick it.
Is it my turn?
Yeah, it's your
turn. Okay. Describe the dream vacation you haven't gotten to take. Then tell me how you can make it happen in 5 years or less.
Well, okay, so I want to go back to the Philippines. But the last time I went, I was 16 years old, and I was with my family. I was young. I couldn't really do anything because I was just like around my parents the whole time because they were very strict. Now that if I can go back, and I'm hoping I can go back next year, but like with COVID and everything, like I don't know. I want to go back to the Philippines. I want to visit Manila, where my grandparents live, and then just like visit like different beaches and stuff because I didn't get to do that last time, so.
You have to vlog that.
Yeah, that'd be a cool vlog. Okay, I honestly don't feel like we're taking the shots because I'm always
okay.
Let's
you
just
know
take
what?
No. Let's just take the shot.
Okay, we'll take this one.
Let's take.
But it's because we need to get to 30.
How about we do mixed mode?
Well, let's
take
our
shot first. Cause
you can go. Freaking washer. Cause it's like spinning right now. What the fuck?
Oh, sorry.
She's like, oh, sorry.
I know.
There was like, some, I didn't mean to do
still
that.
Still have left.
Like, it's almost half of that in there. We leave none behind, girl.
I know that now.
Not here. True or false, great sex requires lube. State your case with first-hand evidence.
False. If a guy is doing the right thing, you'll just be wet on command. That's my theory. But people use lube all the time. I don't see nothing wrong with it. But I've never used it. Have you?
I have.
Yeah.
But it was for something.
Fill in the blank. Defend yourself. I don't care if blank is for kids. I will still love it until I die. Something for like if you do something and like, you know, adults or maybe people your age will say, oh my god, like that's for kids. But you still like doing it, you know?
I don't know.
Half a shot. And pour me half while you're at
okay.
it.
Okay.
Okay, so we had to take a little break, but we're back.
I had to change because I was getting really warm.
I know, it is getting a little bit hot. You want me to go first?
Yeah.
Who was the last person besides your partner or your kids whose junk you've seen?
Dude, that chat roulette.
Okay, so we were on chat roulette like literally last week, and it was just like so much penis.
Oh my god.
Okay, next.
What's a sexual thing what's a sexual thing you've never been able to try but wish you could? Like, what's a fantasy?
Being like tied up or something.
BDSM?
Yeah. Guys be so scared, or like, I don't know, guys. I don't know if guys are into that.
Yeah, like, to me, like, you know those quiet guys?
Yeah.
From what I've like heard.
Yeah.
So.
We will see. We will see. I'm single, so.
Oh, it's my turn.
What will be the sexy nickname that they give you when you live at the old folks' home?
Oh. I've heard of this question. Oh, is this to me?
Yeah. Okay, next.
Sorry. Have I gotten sexier since you've known me?
You always
Can you
good.
Fucking drink?
Oh, shoot. She thinks she doesn't look good, but I feel like she looks the same.
But now I don't even wear makeup here.
True or false? Sometimes it's okay to have unprotected sex. Explain your reasoning. True or false?
Like, it depends on the person. I feel like...
Careful?
Like, scared.
Mm-hmm.
Then do what makes you...
Comfortable with. Yeah.
You know, like...
I feel like if you just know the person, if you've been talking to them for a while and you know they're, like,
and
clean.
And you know them. Yeah.
But then, other than that, you're just... You know, risking yourself for an STD. Honestly, people be like, especially guys, they will just like fuck you,
mm-hmm.
and then like they don't even care. Like a lot of guys don't even get tested.
Yeah,
to be honest,
guys like they don't give a damn.
Yeah, they really don't care.
They don't.
So you gotta find a guy that's like on top of his like.
I feel like you should always use protection.
Yeah. You're not trying to get pregnant.
Yeah.
I'm not trying to get pregnant.
Neither am I. Maybe next year. Have you ever feared for your life or safety while drinking or drugs? Take us to the scene.
I feared for my life, but I was like somewhat sober.
Was it, drugs?
It was alcohol.
Okay, so it had to be with me.
No.
Oh,
No.
Really?
I've always felt safe when I was drinking with her.
Okay,
always.
Good, because I always try to make sure you guys are good.
But this was when I went to Paradiso, that rave.
You went to Paradiso?
Yeah, this was like 2016, I think. Yeah, it was at Paradiso, and it was me and my friend that I'm no longer friends with?
Oh,
that
yeah.
I used to film with?
Yeah.
So it was me and one of my friends, and it was just us two, and we went to Paradiso. We went, we bought, like, the three-day pass, and we went, we drove up there, we parked, we got, like, a camping spot, so we each got tents.
Okay.
So we went into Paradiso, we had fun a little bit, we got, like, a drink, and it was just us two, and we were just, like, drinking a little bit, we were, like... Going around, there's different stages, you know, so we're going around all the stages, and after we went to a few stages, I started getting really bad anxiety.
Was it just off of alcohol?
No, it was just like there's so many people, like I forget how many people there was, like over 25,000 to 30,000.
Were you just on alcohol?
Yeah, it was literally just alcohol.
Did
like
you have a lot?
No, it was, no, I was like
back
really,
then you didn't really
yeah,
drink,
I didn't drink at all, I didn't take any drugs back then. That was when I smoked. And I brought weed, but I didn't smoke before I went into Paradiso because I was scared, like, I was gonna get caught with weed. That's how, like,
really?
Innocent, like,
yeah.
I was with, like, drugs and stuff. So So when we got into Paradiso, like, I got like a margarita type drink, and I drank like half of it. But then, like, after we went to, like, the last stage, I was, like, telling my friend, like, hey, like, I gotta go, like, I don't know what happened to me, but, like, I wanted to, like, cry, and I just wanted to go back, like, and sleep. So I was like, okay, I'm gonna go back by myself. And he's like, yeah, go, go.
Yeah, he should have taken you back himself.
I know, but I felt bad for leaving, and I didn't want, because we bought, like, a 3-day pass.
No, but that doesn't matter. Like, you should always care about your friend.
I know. Yeah, I just, at the end, I just, like, I was gonna go. So I left. And then, like, our car was parked literally, like, I don't know, like, it's, have you ever been to, like, one of those camping areas where it's, like, a ton of cars, just, like, lines of cars?
Yeah, yeah.
So I went to try to go find my car. I couldn't find it for hours.
You drive?
Mm-hmm. I drove the silver car that I had. And then, like, I was trying, I was, like, crying. I was, like,
oh, no.
Oh my god, I can't find my car. And it was, I was by myself. And I was just, like, wandering, like, the whole, like, little parking lot. But it was, like, a grass area. But that was the last time I feared for my life. Because I was, like, oh, my God, I can't get taken right now.
The last thing I would want is for anyone to feel like that.
Yeah.
I would never want to feel like that. That's a scary feeling.
Yeah. But, yeah, that was the last time.
Yeah, what the fuck? Mm.
If I cheat on my partner, is it essential that I tell him? Why or why not?
I feel like yes. Because I would want your boyfriend to do the same.
Yeah, honestly.
For you, have the same respect.
And then after that, you know, whatever he decides.
Yeah.
It's his decision.
It's better than freaking just going on life being lied about.
Yeah, and then just like keeping it in.
Yeah.
I don't like keeping things in.
What's the maximum number of people you'd be interested in having sex with at once?
At once? Girl.
Like an orgy.
No.
Okay, you're drinking, because you can't answer that question.
No, I can't answer that question.
Okay, then you're drinking.
I'll just drink. Drink. Oh my gosh, I'm
already
drunk.
Oh my god.
Wait, what
time? It's only 6:45.
I know. My favorite thing is, like, you guys would know when you're, like, drinking, and then you, like, look at the time, and you're hoping it's not later than it is, and it's like, still super early.
Yeah, like, we're like, okay, we got more time to get, like, lit. Oh my gosh. Oh my god, Hannah's face. I can always tell if it's good or bad with her facial expression.
I know, for real.
You can never keep a neutral face. Mm-hmm.
What did you observe? Oh my gosh.
What? Don't scare me.
What did you observe from porn that you later realized was unrealistic? How did you make this discovery?
Because I've never tried it. No!
Or drink. She's gonna drink.
Okay, true or false? Great sex requires. Oh, I've already asked you that.
Yeah.
Are you a good kisser? How do you know?
Yes.
Do you see these lips? Do you see them? Do you see them? Lips?
I know because I've been told.
Her lips look like she got freaking lip fillers or some shit. Tell us about the first time you ever saw porn.
I don't know. I think it was like when I was in middle school and I had this like girl who rode my bus. She was telling me about it.
Oh, really?
So she was telling me like, hey, like, at that time, like, I had no clue about it. I think I was like in 7th or 8th grade. And I know a lot of people around that time like lose their virginity and stuff like that. So this girl on my bus was telling me about it. And I'm like, what? Like, what is this porn you call?
Oh, you're right.
What is it?
Right.
So I looked it up and I'm just like, okay. I guess this is what people do. Oh my god. And then the worst thing happened to me. I looked that up on my family computer. And then my dad saw the history of it. And he's like, I think it was like the next day or like a few days after. Yeah, he was like, Hannah, come here.
Oh, that's so embarrassing.
I know. He called me over and he's like, what is this? And I'm like, I don't know. I started crying. And he's like, okay, well, don't do this again. And I'm like, okay.
Oh my god.
Okay, so my camera's literally about to die, so we're filming this outro real quick. I hope you guys enjoyed this little drunk kind of Q&A type thing. Let's take our shots real quick.
Yeah.
Before we, well, let me grab my chaser.
Let's take our shot.
We're gonna take our last shots. So hope you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe.
Cheers, girls.